It's not really the start at all. Come on, good afternoon. You know, little bit better. Assalamu alaikum. Okay, that's much better. Okay, I know that's it's a long day, and now we are after the, you know, the lunch, and we are close to the end. But and also, this is the only lucky people in this forum who attend our presentation. So today I'll talk about a project, a small project, and I'll talk about a concept. A lot of people, we think that the volunteering projects, it will help the people who take the service only. But today, I'll explain to you and show you another dimension from the volunteering programs, which is what is the impact on the volunteering programs, with the impact on the companies, on the people, on the team members. It has an impact or not, positive or negative. And I'll show you a small case study. I did it myself with my colleague Mohammed Elias in Kuwait to give you an idea about what is the impact of the volunteer. Actually, we talk about something like common therapy for healthy teams. Also, we talk about how to use the same concept to enhance the communication, why we need it, how can we apply it, case study, result, and conclusion. This is the simple agenda for the 30 minutes. Anyone here in working in project management business? As a project manager, okay, fine. So, for a long, long time, we as a project managers focus on the process. If we have the process in the place, if we have the tools in the place, if you have everything in the place, then everything will be perfect. But actually, this is not correct anymore. Since 2-3 years, even PMI, the one who invented the PMBOK, and they are working in this business since 1969, they said, we discovered that the most important two factors for the project success or fail, people and communication. Why? Because people and communication can make the process work. The process cannot make the people work for a long time. Do you agree or not? If you don't agree, just think about the best project that you managed in your life, or you joined in your life, and ask yourself why this was the best project. Okay. If you don't have any good project in your life, think about what the worst project in your life, and ask yourself the same question. You'll find that the people and the communication are behind the success and fail. Believe me, people can make a great job if they have a good relationship and really manage them in a right way. That's why this, you know, make me focus on this two factors to enhance them. These are the challenges that we face every day. The project is complex, we have stress, we have time constraint, we have a budget constraint, the sponsor just, you know, every day ask about the project, what's happening, what's going on. The customer sometimes, they change their mind. And a lot of things. So this put us in stress, especially if we need to achieve a critical objective. Also, sometimes for some people, the work itself is not meaningful for them. They don't do it for the purpose. They just go to the work back again. Even if they are working a project, just to do some work and back again. And gradually the people will lose their, you know, motivation. So, and if they need to promote them, the company, they don't have a position for them. So they have to continue like this till the end. This is true or not? So what should we do? Also, there are some statistics say that about 71% of the workers are not engaged in their current position. 19% of the workers are actively disengaged. This is a problem. If you don't have good people work with you, if you don't have a good team, if you don't enhance the communication, how can you achieve your project objectives? This is a challenge also, another challenge, which is, I call it hidden negative messages. Sometimes after we walk for a long time, the people start to have some negative feeling. Because of what? Because of the stress of the project. Because many things. Because the competition for the power, for the influence. We have limited resources. We have this, we have that. So, you know, some people, they just send all the day negative message to each other. You know what is hidden negative message? You talk to me and I just, you know, I don't care about what you say. Or maybe in the meetings, people try to just send the messages to each other during the meeting. I hope that you understand what I mean, or you think about it. You know this or not? You practice this or not? You can notice this hidden message or not? Yeah, in some areas I can notice it, and not all. So, okay, fine. Once you go to the HR, say, okay, fine. Dear Mr. HR, we have this problem and we need to encourage people, we need to motivate people. What they will do? Training. Get them a training right away. Those people will send them to training, so the facilitator will come and will play with them some games and they relieve the stress and so on, and after that they will be okay. Okay, no, we can just invite them for a dinner or for a lunch or give them some recognition and you know, such things, and the people will be happy. Actually, all these solutions, from my point of view, is like some, you know, medicine. Maybe you can take it for a while, or not medicine, even like a vitamin. Just empower the people for a while, and later on, you don't remove the real problem. You don't remove the real disease from them. They're still under stress. So this is the challenge. Sometimes we don't have a budget to improve the team performance. There is no available position to give them a promotion. How can we promote people if we don't have a position for them? If they are not qualified for this position, even if we have. So this is the issue. So we need to think about a creative idea. How can we manage this problem? How can we solve this problem? We need some creative ideas. And I think myself about this idea, and I said, okay, fine, let's assume that is that team is like the human body. I know there's a lot of doctors here, so please don't catch me if I make any mistake. Just let it pass. Okay, it's a human body. And the people who are working, they're like the organ in the organization, organs in the organization. So maybe each part, they can do their job very well, but the communication between them, still there is a problem in the communication in the nervous system of this team. A lot of negative message people give it to each other. That means that is the blood circulation or whatever. There is something wrong happened there. The people send this message all the day. All the organs in the body, it's okay. But when they communicate with each other, maybe there is a lot of things in the blood itself. So let us think about some traditional solution, which is the coming therapy. You know the coming therapy? Everyone? Hijama. You know it? You don't know? Okay. Anyways, in some other places when I present this presentation, some other countries, I used to bring all the hijama tools with me to show the people, and it was a big show, actually. I don't practice this, but I try to show them. Anyways, we need to take this, all this, you know, negative message out. We need to take all the stress out. We need to do all the things. So we need to do something like this. But how can we take it out? We need to see how the people communicate with each other. We need to enhance the communication between the team member. We need to get this toxins out. We need to get this negative message out. So what we think is to make another environment, like the work environment, but safe environment. Put the people together. Let them have freedom to discuss. Let us open the hot topics, like heat the places in order to take this toxin out. Let us do this because they have this workload and so on. But how can we take the people to another place and ask them to be free and do whatever they want and discuss the hot topics and all the things? We feel that there is a lot of pain and a lot of problems in the communication related to the cultural diversity, related to there is no healthy communication, depressed employee, toxic relationship, less or not engagement. So what we did is we just need to group them in non-formal communication and see what is the hidden message, what the people feel against each other or each other, and after that get it out. This is NHM, this is what we call it, negative hidden messages. So we need to engage in informal discussion and hear the points and note the message and get it out. I don't want to consume a long time here. So what we need is, we need to make a new project. The project, everyone love it. We need to keep them engaged in this project. We need to know what the personal motivator. You know what is, I don't want to say personal motivator anymore. I need to say selfish motivator. Everyone of us has something called selfish motivator. Something that's pushed him to do something. Something he or she alone know it. So we need to motivate the people. If you don't know what is the selfish motivator for the people, you cannot motivate them. So you need to think about it. You need to invest this. But how can we do it? In the workload, we cannot do it. In the normal environment, we cannot do it unless we are very close friend. So we need a meaningful purpose for the team. Something that they love. Something that if they do it, they will feel happy. By the way, the volunteer work make the people happy. And I'll show it to you, the statistics. We need a team to do project outside the company. We need them to deal with each other equally, without any formal title, without any rank. We need to discover their talent itself. Because at work, we have an accountant, right? HR, doctor, engineer, by profession. So what we think about those people? They are only know this only. They don't discover more talent. Maybe this accountant also can do graphic design. Maybe there's a talent in this, but we don't know. Because when we think about the people, we just think of it by title. What is their title? Then if I said, okay, I'm an accountant, then you will see me as an accountant. You have like perception or, you know. So this is the idea, to engage the team in a volunteering project. This is the idea that came to our mind, to just, if we engage the people in the volunteering project, if this will make the team perform better? We need to engage them for a project that they like. Not a formal project, not a company project, not the organization project. I not do some volunteering job in order to make a company project. Just I need them to do any project. This is the idea behind it. But can this really solve the problem? Can this solve the problem in the normal work later on if we send the people for a volunteering project? What they will gain from this project? What we will gain from this project? Yes. Actually, in volunteering project, since there is no money, there is no title, there is nothing, the people become more free, more casual. And also the volunteer work, we can know easily what is the selfish motivator for each one. Also in the volunteer work, the people feel good about themselves. Anyone here engaged in volunteering project before? Just raise your hand. Do you feel it's good or not? After you do it, you feel good or not? Do you feel good about others also or not? Other colleagues, even if we have some discussion, home discussion, some debates, some whatever, some conflict even sometimes. But at the end of the day, we feel that we are do this for just a very high purpose. It's not for money, not for title. So we are thinking about what are the corporate volunteering programs. Some companies, some organizations, some government, they give money, and others, they go and sponsor some programs, which is fantastic, very good. But there's other companies, they send their employees themselves to do a volunteering work. Oh my God, the company will stop the work and send the people for volunteering program? Yes, I tell you why. Because they stop the work and send them for training, right? Consider this as a training. But actually it's on-job training. Deloitte, for example, they have a program called Pro Bono program. This is an example of how the concept will be applied globally. And they said that after they do this program and work for a long time, they increase the employee engagement. They open a career opportunity to the team members. I tell you why, because even in the voluntary work, there is an opportunity. Maybe I'm working as an accountant in my company, but I'm a head of some team. We are doing a volunteering work, so at least I satisfy my need to have a rank, to have a position. Also increase the team reality. This is Deloitte. Moody Afternoon Service, also they do the same program. They make a program afternoon so that we can just give service to the society afternoon. And they say that the president of this Moody Foundation, he said that this group, who they send them to a volunteer work, or people, they said, 100% say they found that activity to be reward or very rewarding. 67 built relationships with colleagues that they don't usually work with. 51 felt better about the company, and 50 felt better about themselves. Okay. So, this is, I don't know if you know, but this is the Maslow hierarchy of needs. After that, they improve it and add some level, and this is show the needs of the people. And if you put it at the top, what is the top? This is the new one. The need to give. So we make a program, just I show a case study for this program volunteer. We have a program called Young Project Manager Camp. This is a case study happened in spring 2011. Me, myself, and this is my team who are working with me voluntarily in this initiative. We are all from the same company, maybe the logo is there, lifelong. So we together, I gathered my team and said, okay, let us do some volunteering work. So what we'll do, we'll teach project management to kids from 8 to 12 years old. Because of project management, we believe it's like a skill, life skill. So we can teach it for the kids. Actually, I have like an agreement with BMI Education Foundation to give them the material, to review the material, to approve the program, and that's what we did. I tried to just go through the program. Actually, this program, in order to make it and engage the kids, we make it in the service. In the service, because of what? Because the service is a complete project. Even the show itself, it's a project. To build it, it's a project. To move it, it's a project. So it's a project. It has a schedule, scope, schedule, budget, risk, quality, procurement, everything that you can imagine in the project management, you'll find it there. So, and on top of all the things, the kids love it. So what happened is, the circus is fun, so we have all the complete project in the circus, so the kids will learn how to do the scope, how to do schedule, how to do budget, risk, everything. This is my team in the beginning. We sat together, we discussed, and this is not a secret. Some of them are managers, some of them are not managers, so even the managers try to manipulate things and make it, you know, like they have to be managers also in the volunteering job. But actually, we remove all the ranks, everything. We try to get out all this negative message. And I try to play the role of the servant leader. We put a ground rule that rotation is a must. So if someone do the role today, the other one will do it next. This program, it was 1 month program. 1 month program every Saturday. So we take the kids every Saturday and we work with them to build the project and to know project management. Freedom, everyone free to do whatever he wants or she wants. By the way, all of them are ladies. I don't choose them ladies, but this has come by chance. It's more active maybe in the volunteering work. All of them are equal in rank. There is no manager, there is no staff. Everyone is equal, and this is what the beauty of this program. And actually, this program, later on, I'll tell you how we discover a lot of talent from the people there. And the commitment. I play the role of the servant leader. Servant leader means what? Means only my role is just give them the vision, remove all the blocks, support them, give them the resources. That's it. All the decisions, they can take it themselves. Just I try to support and let them think how to take a decision if you are a leader. Also, this was one of the leadership programs that I would like to give it to them. This is the program agenda. We have about four Saturdays. The first one was workshop in project management and mind mapping. Second workshop in the project management concepts and apply in the service itself, how to make it in the service. The third one was to practice how to apply what they learn. And the fourth one was to complete the project and graduation ceremony. In the beginning, we shared it like one lead trainer, four facilitators, one organizer, one safety officer, because we are dealing with kids. If you meet a complete case study, just drop your card here and I send it to you, because in sake of time, it's just 30 minutes, so I go so fast on it. This is the first day, it was in the class, and you feel that the kids feel it's very boring, but gradually, the team start working with them, and we have a lot of fun even in the class. And as you see here, by the way, this lady, she's working in the company to prepare the to be like a secretary for the corporate sales. But actually in this program, we discovered that she can build the curriculums because she built this curriculum. And this is her talent, and this is what she needs in her life. Another one, which is accountant, and we discovered that she's very talented in the graphics and the designs and all these things. And we discovered a lot of talents actually during this project. So this is the first day they introduce the introduction to project management, and they teach. This is the first time they teach, but they love teaching. So they practice. This is also some pictures from the first day. As you see here, you know what they do? They make a brainstorming session. So the kids make a brainstorming session. They make a mind map. They know how to make a brainstorming. So when they grow, they know what is brainstorming. Brainstorming, not only storming. Because sometimes we start the brainstorming in the beginning and we end only with storming. So they learn how to make a mind map and how to, they put the projects in practice and they have fun on this day. And we have a closing and everyone have something to go home with, like the mind map. This is the first day. They know what is the project management, they know how to make a mind map, they know the difference between the projects, and they make something like project charter, but not very professional. So the team themselves, they go back, they know more about each other, they engage more with the project objective, they enhance the communication, they deal with each other better, they change the perception toward each other, and more motivated for the next step. This is the team. Not the kids, they go home with something, and the team with another thing, and the company get a benefit at the end from this. This is the second day, it was in the service itself. So we went there, we with the team. This is me myself. And this is the operation manager in the company. She teaches project management in this day to them. And we give them like a t-shirt, and they write in the back of the t-shirt, I am the project manager, and also we give them a business card, as I am the project manager, to introduce themselves to others. Actually, they take it and they give it to all their colleagues at the school. They learn what the WBS, what the breakdown structure, but we don't call it WBS, we call it Project 3, to make it very simple for them. So they learn the WBS and the critical path method, they make it very simple one, and they make a project, and they all have fun, and they practice. And the CPM, which is very critical concept, they know it. They make like a schedule, and they make it at the end. And as you see here, they make the WBS and the critical path. This is the service staff themselves. They come to teach them about risk management, how they manage the risk, how they manage the project, how to make it in the scope. This is inside the service itself. And they have the second day finished, and they are very happy. This is in the show. Even in the show, they engage in the show, and they make a live show in front of the other people. So the clown played the role of the project manager, and he take our kids and make a complete program for them, and they can play music and everything in the real show. And they celebrate at the end. And this is a lot of lessons they get it out. They know how to create the project scope, how to make the network diagram, how to identify the risk, because the circus is very unsafe environment in terms of risk. So they show them how they manage the risk there. They know how to manage the human resource and quality and celebrate the success. This is the second day, and for sure the team, our team, back again with really, really, they become an excellent team. They have very high team spirit after this. If you join this project, you will feel what I know, what they say. So they are very happy. Even they learn how to do, but what is the impact of body language? You know why? Because the circus team itself, they deal with acts with each other by the body language, so they can understand the others, and we teach this to our team, and we empower the team. And this is the third day, actually. The kids come to make a project, so make a sample project. So they go and they have the area, they define the scope, they choose the location, and they start to build it, develop the project plan. Project sponsor approve, so each of our staff play the role of a project sponsor, so they approve the budget and the scope and sign it. And they take the check and they go to the bank. We make a complete simulation. And after that, they take the money, they go to do procurement, they learn how to negotiate. This is also our staff play this role with them, and they negotiate and they get the, whatever they want, and after that, they build the circus. This is the circus that they built, small one. The project complete. Kids learn how to plan the project, how to execute it, and how to close it. And also our team become more, they have more creative ideas. By the way, if you deal with the kids, you will have a lot of creative ideas. Believe me, they make a complete media, they use the iPad and all the things to record the sales and all the things, and they make a complete marketing campaign, which we don't ask them to do it, but they did it. And if you see the show and how they dance and how they promote the sales, you will love to have them in your company to promote whatever your products. So this is the fourth day, was make the closing report. So we ask the kids to make a report about this project, what went well, what went wrong. If we need to do it again, how can we make it better? And after that, we celebrate, give them the certificates and business cards with young project manager title. This is the cake. And this is after we complete the program, we ask the parents, what is the impact of this project on the kids? And the parents, they are more than happy. And some of them told me that my daughter, I found her teach her mother how the pizza, how making pizza is a project. And she told her how to buy the things, how to make a schedule for it, the scope, blah, 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 the budget and everything. For sure, the pizza sponsor is the husband. And normally we pay a lot of money to buy a lot of things for a small pizza. Anyways. And we finish it, everyone. So what we discovered, in just a summary, volunteering projects prove with no doubt that it has a very positive impact on the people who are working in the project, as well as the people that you serve. The people that you serve, we know it. This dimension is very clear and we know it very well. But what the people they don't know is, the people who are working in this project also, they learn a lot. Discover a lot of talent, discover a lot of things, get out all the negative message from the team, and this team worked together at least for 1 year after this program, very efficient, perfect. The first 6 months was excellent. After that, gradually, things become not as. So if you need a better performance, try to think about the company volunteering programs. This is very important to engage the people. If you need to serve the society also and make a good image for your company, your organization, think about the volunteering program. If you need the people to engage in your company or your organization and work for a purpose really, then think about this volunteering program. Plus, this will let you as a leader or the manager to discover the talent, to discover who can you promote later on. That's all. Thank you very much.